Welcome to day 22 of our 28-day yoga challenge. Remember to complete the class, like the video, comment below that you've completed the class, and make sure you've subscribed. Every class you complete is one entry or two for Dash Yoga members. Now go enjoy some free yoga.
Everybody, welcome back to our February challenge. Today is day 22. My name is Ashleigh and I'm going to be taking you through a yoga fusion. There's so much great feedback on the first one. I wanted to squeeze another one in. So yoga fusion is a mixture of strength training as well as some yoga. So today I have a couple weights. If you don't have weights, you can obviously do this equipment free and just work with your body weight. If you want to add a little something and again, you don't have weights, you can use a water bottle, some canned goods, or anything with a little bit of heaviness to it. So we're actually gonna start just in a standing position. So just coming towards Tadasana at the top of the mat. Stand up tall, lift your shoulder heads towards the ears and then drop the shoulders down the back. And just starting to focus on your breath, moving inwards and feeling the steadiness of the earth beneath your feet. Allow your toes to become softer, maybe have a gentle bend in the knee. And really feeling your feet, the earth, your mat, the ground, just holding you. And as you take a few deep breaths in and out, come into the present moment and just feel into yourselves and your bodies and your hearts. And notice if you feel called to set an intention for our time together today. And just repeating those words or ideas in your mind, being very clear, my intention is blank. Allowing the universe, your guides, to support you during this time. Make a little commitment to yourself as well to honor where you're at, to show up exactly as you are, to do as much as you can, modify, add some extras, but most importantly, have fun and always be safe. So we're gonna take 1 to 2 more breaths, just taking it all in. Taking the gaze down towards the ground, eyes are gonna open. I'm turning to face you, but again, just coming into a comfortable spot. We're gonna bring the arms up and just starting to walk. Lift the knees up nice and high. Start to find your breath. Maybe lift the legs up a little higher. Find a nice rhythm that works for you. I'm gonna go for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Put the weight into the left foot, lift your right leg up. You can bring the hands in front of the heart and we're gonna roll circles out with the knee. Just creating a little bit of extra space within the hips. Go inwards. Good, switch legs, put the weight in the right foot, pick the left leg up, knee is bent, circle out. You can always use your hand on the wall to find balance as well if you need. Go in. Awesome. Now we're gonna come back to that walking action. We're gonna bring the fingertips up to the temples, opposite knee to opposite elbow, adding a little twist. You can go slower. You can intensify, go a little faster. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Beautiful. Now we're gonna bring the arms out and taking the feet a little wider. We're gonna do our star kick. So left foot's gonna come across, try to tap the right hand, right foot to left hand. Just find a nice rhythm that works for you. Stay more upright, strong core. Good. Find a rhythm that works for you. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. One more round, just starting to walk, lift the knees nice and high. Can be a little lighter as well, or even a gentle pulse, just staying on the ball mounts. three, two, and one. Weight into the left foot, hands come up, circle out with the right leg. Circle in. Switch, pick the left foot up, circle out. Go in. Beautiful. Lift the elbows up or fingertips by the temples. We're coming across. So you could also pull down if that aligns with you. Feel that little bit of fire. Three, two, and one. Good. Arms out nice and wide. Your star kicks left to right, right to left. Last three, two, and one. Awesome job. Always have a quick sip of water if you need. We're gonna grab one weight. Weight into the left hand, having your feet about hip distance apart. Right fingertips can come to your temples. Draw your navel in. Start to side dip over to the left and then come up. Down. Feel a nice stretch through your right side body. Stay with your breath. Two more. And switch. Weight into the right hand, left fingertips up, side bend over to the right. Strong core. Last two. And one, beautiful. Grab the weight with both hands. We're gonna take the weight nice and high. We're gonna bend the elbows, drop the weight in between the shoulder blades, and then reach back towards the sky for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and one. Beautiful. Take the weight out in front of your chest. Lift the heels up. Lower your heels down. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it up. Think about tucking your heels behind the creases of your ankles. Beautiful. Come down, weight into the left hand, right fingertips up. Last round of all three exercises. Going to the left. Side bend. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, last one. Switch to the right, left fingertips up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Beautiful. Weight up, bend the elbows, drop it down. We're gonna go for 15 as well. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Beautiful. Weight in front of your chest. Heel lifts up and down. Up and down. Keep going. Five, four, three, two. Hold the last one up. Good. Heels down. Release your weights. Shake your arms out. Come to the top of the mat if you're not already there. Have a sip of water if you need. Interlace the hands behind the back. Draw your fists down. Float the chest up. Inhale. Exhale. Fold forwards. Melt over your legs. Nod the head yes and no. Walk the fingertips up onto your shins. Halfway lift, lengthen. Exhale and fold. Walk the hands over to the left side of your mat. Stay here and bow over your left knee. Or take your right hand to the back of the left ankle. The left hand finds the back of your right ankle. Bend your elbows apart as you soften over your left thigh and knee more and more. Walk your fingertips back to the front of the mat. Come up halfway. Lengthen your back, flat back. Exhale, bow. Walk your hands over to the right side. Melt over your right knee. Option to take left hand behind right knee. Right hand behind left. Bend your elbows apart and soften. Perfect. Walk your hands back to the front of your mat. Lengthen. Plant the palms. Step back, downward dog. And as you come to your dog, take a nice pedal. Bending into one knee, drop the opposite heel. Keep lengthening your tailbone tall to the sky. Eventually, traction your heels. Press into your hands a little bit more as your tailbone continues to lift. Very good. Shift forwards to plank. Lower your knees down towards the mat. Turn your fingertips in towards your knees, cat and cow. Inhale, belly down, heart opens. Exhale, round and crawl. Keep going. Very good. Turn the fingertips to the outer edge of the mat. Shift your weight side to side. Feel the weight distribute between the heel of the hand, the knuckles, and the fingertips. Maybe even bending the elbows a little bit. Just playing with the shape that works best for you. Now turn the tops of your hands onto the mat. Fingertips point in. You can have a juicy bend in the elbow. Perhaps straighten. Maybe curl your fingertips in towards the palm. And you can shift the weight back. Beautiful. Unravel one hand at a time. Maybe shake it out or open and close the fingers. And then you have the option to take a weight into the back of your sort of left knee crease. Snuggle it in there. You can do this without a weight as well. If you had a resistant band as well, you could also play around with different shapes there. So just again, see what works for you. We're going to keep the toes tucked under, lifting the left knee up and taking it out to the side for a fire hydrant type of shape, and then lowering down to hover. For one, two, three. Keep drawing your belly button in. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Kick your left foot up towards the sky. We're gonna just do a little pulse here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, down, switch. Good work. Weight behind the crease of your right knee, squeeze it in there. Beautiful. You can again do this weightless or perhaps with a resistant band. Lift the right knee to hover. We're taking the right leg out to the side, fire hydrant, and lower belly button draws in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pulse your right foot towards the sky. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work. Take your weight off. And now, right toes are gonna point back. Bring your bum towards the ground and extend your left leg forwards. Think about this sort of like your half hero. So you're not quite sitting on your right heel. The foot is actually beside your hip. Toes point back. Sit up nice and tall. Flex your left toes. Inhale, circle your arms towards the sky. Exhale, bow over your leg. You can come any amount. You can add a little pulse here, up and down, or maybe even just taking stillness. No right or wrong. For you to close your eyes and look in, where are the spots that you can breathe even deeper? Finding that little bit of connection with yourselves more and more. Come all the way up, extend your right leg forwards. Point your left toes back. Clear your sits bones if you need to. Sit up nice and tall, breathe it in. And then begin to hinge forwards, any amount. Longer spine, the tops of your shoulder heads soften. Maybe you reach, maybe you add a little pulse. Feel into the needs of your own body here. Beautiful, come all the way up. Left leg extends forwards, clear your sits bones again. So you're just moving the fleshy part, the juicy part of your bum out of the way so your bony part can really dig down. Inhale, arms come up. Exhale, bow over both legs. Try to do your best to be mindful of keeping more of a neutral spine so you're leading forwards with the heart instead of the nose, which might just avoid the round to find space in your back body. Three, two, and one. Come up, cross at the ankles, take the hands out, step back to your dog. Come forwards to your plank. You're gonna jump your feet wide off the mat, jump the feet back, right hand to left shoulder, left hand to right shoulder. Feet wide, feet back, tap left, tap right, out, in, left, right, out, in, left, right, out, in, left, right, out, in, left, right. Last one, out, in, left, right. Lower down to the belly. Interlace the hands behind your back, make a fist. Inhale, peel your forehead, chest, arms and legs up. Exhale, return to the mat. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift and hold. Exhale, lower. Release the hands. Create a table for your forehead at the top of your mat. Bend the knees, windshield wiper the legs. Beautiful. Walk your fingertips off to the side. Three roll-ups. Tense your fingers. Peel yourself up. You can keep a nice bent elbow. You might start to straighten. feet might organically spread apart. That's okay. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, down. Inhale, lift and hold. Look over your left shoulder. Look over your right shoulder. Lower back down to the earth. Hands right beside your side ribs. Come up cobra or up dog. Exhale over your toes. Downward facing dog. Right leg's gonna lift. Breathe it in. Exhale, step through high lunge. Arms float to the sky. Hug your right hip back. Hands melt in towards the heart, making a prayer pose. Position with the palms touching, left elbow across right thigh. As you press into your palms, feel your chest open more towards the right. Perfect, come back up, nice high lunge. Hinge at the waist, low runner's lunge. Weight into the right foot, hop your left leg up, warrior three. Any arms? And then bow over your leg, grab the back of your right ankle with one or both hands. Standing split. Elevate your top leg. Hands to the mat, jump, hop, or step back. Cycle through a vinyasa. Optional handstand kick-ups there if you practice. Left leg rises, inhale. Exhale, left foot steps through, rise up, high lunge. Draw your hands into heart center. Right elbow across left thigh, press into your palms, continue to twist to the left. Drag the right heel back. Arms float back to the sky. Hinge at the waist, low runners. Put the weight into the left foot, hop up with grace. Warrior three, any arms. Hands to the earth, bow over your left leg, take your right leg higher. Maybe left hand wraps around the left ankle. Maybe both hands eventually. Hands to the mat, jump, hop, or step back, cycle through your flow, or handstand kick-ups. Jump through to seated and make your way onto your backs. Bend the knees, cross the right ankle over left thigh, flex your foot, and use your right hand to press the right leg away. You can stay here or lift the left leg. Interlace under the left hamstring or around your left shin. Feel yourself. Draw the left leg closer towards your body, and at the same time, can your right elbow press your right thigh away from you? Head, shoulders, and low back are the areas that you're trying to soften bit by bit. Left foot comes down, right foot comes down. Melt your arms, windshield wiper the legs. Second side, left ankle over right thigh, flex the foot. Left hand can press left leg away, this is great. Or lift your right leg, interlace underneath the right hamstring or around the right shin. Feel your back body continue to surrender. Maybe use your left elbow to press the left thigh away if that's accessible. Please place your feet to the mat, windshield wiper the legs. And then soles of the feet come to touch, knees open. You're gonna take the arms alongside the body, just as if you were going into bridge. Press into your palms, lift your hips up. Squeeze your glutes at the top. We're gonna lower to hover or touch lightly and then lift back up for 10, 9, 8, seven, six, five, four, three, two, hold it up at the top, and lower down. Big breath in. Exhale, big sigh out. Soles of the feet to the mat, knees point to the ceiling, arms rise up to a T or cactus if you're tight for room. Wrap right leg over the left, drop your legs to the left side, gaze over your right shoulder. Unclench your jaw, melt into it. Inhale back through, unravel the legs. On the exhale, reset. Left leg over the right, drop your legs to the right, look to the left. Right hand can anchor the left leg down. Notice if there's any areas that you are unintentionally holding tension. Inhale, come back through to center. Hug both knees in. Nose up to your knees. Give yourself a beautiful squeeze. Lower down and finding your final resting pose, your shavasana today. Just taking the next few moments to be soft and still, knowing that you've already done the work. So now it's time to just be in your stillness. Taking in the energy and the effort of the practice. And no matter what time of day you're doing this class, try to honor and let go of anything that's already happened today. Do your best to loosen the grasp on anything that might be happening later tonight or tomorrow. And land in this present moment in your body, watching yourself rest, reset, and replenish. Feel yourself start to reawaken, coming back to the subtle noises and sounds around you. Feel your belly rise and fall. And then begin to wiggle the fingers and toes. Take a full body stretch, float your arms back, elongate your toes forward. Take a breath in. Exaggerated sigh out. Roll onto the side of your choice and then come all the way up to seated, hands at your heart, eyes closed, bowing down and honoring the student, the teacher, the soul inside of you. Thank you for sharing in this practice with me as well as each other. Have an amazing rest of your day. Namaste.